morning. All at once I looked and you were gone. Now you're looking back at me, such a far away that we can be, like we were before. Never back to what I knew before you. Somehow it seems it doesn't look the same. Give my life for one more night. Having you here the only time of day. Take me there again. Whoa. And I remember how you loved me. Time is all we had until the day we said goodbye. Was in the summer night. Still recall the walks along the beaches and the way your hair would glisten in the sun. Rising in the afternoon, making love to you under the moon. Oh. Remember all the nights we spent inside. Every single breath you took was mine. We can have it all again. Say that you'll be with me when the sun brings your heart to mine. Yeah. And I remember how you loved me. There's only so much I can say, so please don't worry about what we have together. It's only you and me tonight, so let's stay lost and fly. Won't you please surrender?
For what one man pushed you through,
waste around. Won't you let me be the one, baby? This time, there ain't nothing gonna change this heart with no more goodbyes. There ain't nothing gonna change my heart away. Don't keep the dreaming, you locked outside your door. Just believe in this love, and don't be afraid anymore.
Oh,
gonna stamp it till I set it straight. Don't you know? Yeah, I'm gonna stamp it till I set it straight. Don't you know? Don't you know? Ain't gonna stop until my... Don't let me down, don't you know? Ain't gonna stop until my... Little lamb, don't you know? Ain't gonna stop until my...
Boulder. How are you? Good to see you. Thanks for coming. Glad to be here. It's been a long time. Everybody good? Sunday night? Okay, so I don't know how many of you understand or understood before you bought tickets that this is sort of, this is it, pretty much. There will be no introducing the band. There will be no drum solos. It's me and you tonight. I started doing shows like this about a little less than 2 years ago, and I've just had so much fun going all over the world, actually, doing these solo acoustic shows. And it's fun for me because I just sort of take you guys through my whole songwriting career and play you snippets from different periods. Mostly play you songs I think you'll know. Now, a couple of them I'm going to do tonight, you may... No, but you didn't know I had anything to do with it, because I do write songs with and for other artists, so I'm going to do a couple of those tonight, too. But basically, we're just going to hang out. I think sometimes when people see acoustic, solo acoustic, I always think that's a serious singer-songwriter show, which is fine for some people, but that's so not what this is. I think you can already tell. So I welcome any kind of crazy, insane behavior. I love when people yell shit out. That's awesome. I love when you yell songs out. I prefer that they're my songs. Oh, dude! So here's the deal. I know that in your mind, you're thinking, oh my god, it would be so funny if I yelled out Freebird really loud. But then when you do it, the truth is that everybody else in the room just goes, what a dick. I'm saying this to your brother. I don't know for you. So we're going to do right now, out of love, we're going to do what I call a free bird intervention. Because friends don't let other friends yell out free bird. It's boring. It's like, of all the songs, it's like, dude, really? That's all you got? Free bird? So here's the deal. What's your name? Oh, come on. You were brave a second ago. Right. Mike? Ryan? Okay. Greg. Repeat after me, Ryan.
Greg.
Ryan.
Greg.
Ryan. The hearing, by the way, is the second thing to go. Ryan. With a B? Like, you bastard Brian? I, Brian. Repeat after me. Come on.
I, Brian.
Will never. yell out Freebird in a crowded place ever again. Well, fuck you! We were doing I still say we. I was doing a show not that long ago, like a year ago, and a guy yelled out, Summer 69! And he wasn't, on my mind, he wasn't being a dick. This guy actually thought I was the guy that sang Summer 69. So, without 3 seconds delay, I just went, I got my first real 69! And then, like, literally, this is a true story, then, like, 4 months later, Brian Adams came to Chicago, where I live, and we're not close pals, but I've known him off and on over the years, and he was nice enough to invite me and my wife to his show. So we went to see his show, which was awesome, and we went back to say hi, and we were talking and kind of catching up, and I told him about that happening. We were laughing, and I said, does anybody ever yell out my songs at your show? And he went, no. So do me a favor, if Brian Adams comes to play here in Boulder, go see him, because he's awesome. But yell out my songs all night. Alright, I'm going to carry on now. This is a song, it was a hit for me back in 1991. It's called Keep Coming Back. Oh,
Thank you.
love you too. I love you too. I love you too. But I do feel the need to see other people. All right, I gotta set this song up a little bit. This song also comes from the early 90s, and I wrote this piece of music for this song. I was out on this really long tour, and I was in the back of my tour bus one night, traveling across the country, and this piece of music just sort of came into my head, and I got really excited about it because it didn't sound like any other piece of music I'd ever written. And that's what all of us songwriters are always going after, you know, trying not to write the same old shit. And so I really loved this piece of music, and I wanted the lyrics to be special. I wanted them to be just as special as I thought the music was. So I knew it didn't sound like a love song, and it was certainly not like an up-tempo rock song. And ever since I was a little kid, I've been a big fan of mystery novels and suspense thrillers and stuff like that. So I thought, wouldn't it be badass if I could write a story song to this piece of music? Yeah. And like with a plot and characters and everything. So I got an idea going in my head, and I was pretty excited, and I started to work on it. And the more I worked on it, the more I knew, beyond a shadow of a doubt, that it sucked. That it was maybe the worst song ever written, ever. But I was almost done with it, even though by that point I knew it was just garbage. And so I thought, alright, I'll sing it down one time into a machine just so I have it. This is just the worst song. So I went up to my music room and started to play and sing the song down. And my wife, Cynthia, came to get me for dinner. And she opened the door and just kind of saw that I was recording, so she waited until I was done. I finished and I stopped the recorder, and she looked at me and she went, "Oh my God, what is that song?" And I went, this piece of crap? It's this stupid song I've been working on for weeks. It's this story song about a little town in Nebraska. There's a girl that lives in this town. There's a river that runs through the town. There's a girl that lives there named Mary. And one day Mary just vanishes. She just disappears and no one knows what happened to her. And I'm the narrator of the song, but I'm also a character in the story. I'm this weird guy who lives in the town. And people think, ooh, he had something to do with Mary's disappearance. This is like the worst Twin Peaks episode ever aired. And she said, "Babe, that is a huge hit song." Okay, now this is the most important part of my story, especially for you guys here tonight. You know, husbands and boyfriends particularly. Because as you know, all we want every once in a while is to be freaking right. Because we're never right. Ever. So I thought, this is exciting. I'm right about this. This is what I do for a living. I know what I'm talking about. So I have to admit, all these years later, that the only reason I recorded this song at all, at great expense, was to prove my wife wrong. To show her that by putting it on the new album, that no one would like it, no one would pay attention to it, and I could say, see, told you. So I recorded it, and I put it on the album, and about 4.5 months later, it was number one in 14 countries. We all have Cynthia to thank for this one. This is called Hazard. My mother came to Hazard when I was just 7. He and then the folks in town took a prejudice night. Years ago when I came to know Mary, first time someone loved beyond the rumors and the lies, saw the man beside. We used to walk Really psyched to hear it on the radio, and at the end of the song, the DJ came on and he said something like, "That's brand new from Richard Marx, and next up, Lady Gaga." I swear to God, it was unbelievably cool, because it hit me right then and there that almost every time I hear one of my songs on the radio now, the guy comes on at the end and he goes, "That was Richard Marx, and next up is Bette Midler's Wind Beneath My Wings."
Thank you.
Before that, we had the Carpenters. Not that day, man. That day, I was sandwiched between Nickelback and Lady Gaga. It's called When You Loved Me. Trust my eyes, you look at me, and I can't breathe. And every word perfect for when this day would come, but standing here now, I can't find even one. All I want to say is when you're on my face. Songs, sometimes it just creates this sort of, it's not Alzheimer's, but it's Halfheimer's songs, you know?
Should have known better.
Well, it's turning into a free-for-all. So, okay, I'm coming down there and I'm going to kick your ass. I know I don't work like much, but it's the other ones you're gonna worry about. I'm telling you right now. I opened for Night Ranger once years ago. They turned my sound off in the middle of my show. I know, dicks, right? I was out on this really long summer tour opening. This is my first tour
opening for REO Speedwagon,
who were the most awesome guys ever.
Yeah.
And they used to, like, I'd heard all these horror stories about when you're opening, when you're the opening act for bands, that they're just, you know, that the headlining acts are always treat the opening act really badly. And so I was ready. It was almost like I was out there like,
I don't know what we're going to do, but...
So we were just ready for REO to be complete dicks. And we got sound checks every night, and they would go on radio interviews, and they'd say, hey, everybody, get out there early and check out Richard Marx and his band. They were just like the nicest, coolest guys. So we did this whole summer tour with them, and then they took a couple of weeks off, and I couldn't be out of work, so I took this couple of nights opening for Night Ranger, thinking, this is just the way it is. Everybody's like REO Speedwagon. We got to our last song, and it was like, don't be... Turned our sound off. That was kind of a bummer. So you think I'm going to do one of their songs? No.
But
I can't fight this feeling anymore. I forget what I started fighting for.
I seem to have an REO Speedwagon song. A, to pay tribute to my friends, and B, to piss you off. Hey, I want to do one of these songs that I told you about that I wrote for, actually in this case, with another artist. Do we have any country music fans here? Cool, because I'm going to do a jazz number now. I wrote this song. I've been going to Nashville off and on for years, writing different country artists, and I've had the most success with a guy named Keith Urban. Years ago, like 7 years ago, maybe, the first song we wrote together was a big hit for him called Better Life.
Someday, baby, you and I will be the ones, good enough's gonna shine.
Remember that song? And then we had another hit called Everybody, and then last year we wrote a song that went to number one again, and I want to do that one for you. It's called Long Hot Summer.
I can't sleep, ain't sleeping coming, I'm just lying here thinking about you. I've been deep, falling deep into the picture in my mind of everything we're gonna do. Over at the lake and down by the river, you can feel it start to rise. Won't be jumping like a car, go wherever you are, cause I need you by my side. Yeah. It's gonna be a long hot summer. We should be together with the peanut butter and dance floor now. So we belong in the daylight, such a beautiful sight. Sun to go down, sun to go down. I want to see your brown skin shimmer in the sun for the first time. I gotta be the one who knows just what to do to you to get me that smile. One chance to meet you, won't let me sleep when I said hi. That was the beginning of my heart spinning like there's wheels in my head tonight. It's gonna be a long hot summer. We should be together with your feet up on the dance floor now. So get along in the rain, hold me so to feel the motion. Cause we just say my name in the middle of the day. I swear that I see the stars now. Thank you.
I want to try something for you. I've only done a couple times. I just wrote this song a few weeks ago, and I want to just play it for you because I was thinking, you know, I've been lucky enough to have had some hits on country radio with different country artists, you know, with Keith, with Vince Gill, with Emerson.